Robbie Starnes has asked how to paint the fire effects on the Scorched Greatfray. So in today's video, we're going to show you how to do that. Now, the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model. And I've gone with Mechanica Standard Grey because it's a nice, easy colour scheme to show this. Now, the first colour we'll use a Baden Black. We'll then start the fire effects by painting with a Mephiston Red. We'll then follow that with Wild Rider Red. Then we'll use Fire Dragon Bright as the last part of the flame. And if we need to, at the very end, we'll tidy it with some Baden Black again, just to make that black look a bit darker. So first of all, let's start with the Baden Black. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to be painting the horns and the axe on this guy. And also, when we get around to doing the fire effects themselves, I'll be using dry brushes and I'll also be doing some recess washes, but they'll be using the same colours in each stage. So first of all, let's get some of that black on. So I'll just pull up the model. So what we've got is his axe to do, so I'll just base coat that. You might have to do a couple of coats on the grey, but one should be enough. Then we've got the horns to do as well. So with the black now base coated, the first thing I'm going to do is do a recess shade of Mephiston Red on the horns. Then I'm going to follow that with a dry brush of Mephiston Red on the axe. So you can see I'm just running this into the cracks like so. Now this is two parts water to one part red. So just pile that in like that, and we're just going to move to the dry brush on the actual axe, and we're just keeping to the edges so it really picks out. I have to do a couple of goes of this just to add some brightness to that, but you can see if you just put a bit of pressure down, you can start to get some nice red edges there. With the red now applied, we're going to use Wild Rider Red, and again we're going to do a recess shade. Again, that's one part paint, two parts water. Just going to run that into the recesses of the horns. That will make it look a little bit more fiery as it starts to dry. And also on the weapon, just dry brushing a bit lighter just on those edges to help that Wild Rider Red really pop out. Again, we still want to see some of that Mephiston Red underneath, so don't go too heavy when you do your dry brush. Using Fire Dragon Bright, we're now going to start applying that as a recess shade just here. Again, two parts water, one part paint. We'll do the dry brush version on the axe in a moment or two. Just let that sink in there, and then we're just going to start dry brushing. Again, this is really soft. I'm just going to go in some of the corners and probably just pick out those rivets as well. And finally, we're just going to move back to a Baden Black, and we're just going to tidy up some of those raised areas. So on the horns, we're just going to try and define those horns a bit more. So it really helps those fiery glows in the recesses really stand out. And if we just go onto the axe, all we're doing here is just going over those panels just to try and remove some of where that dry brush residue is, just to really make that black really pop out. And there we are, the fire effects of the Scorched Greatfray are done. So I hope you found that useful, Robbie. Keep sending those requests in, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.